I'm excited. I think that the big announcement that he's running for mayor for a third term after taking some time off. When did he finish? In eight? I think he ran, from 2000 to 2008?
Was there Ralph after him?
Yeah, Ralph Becker.
Then Biskupski.
Then Biskupski. Aaron Mendenhall.
Now we've got Patrick just ran out of the studio. I think Rocky's here.
Well, that's perfect.
I think he just ran out to get Rocky.
I'm actually looking forward to this interview, and I love the fact that he's coming into the studio. This is like Belly of the Beast moment right here. I've done this. I remember going into some very hostile territories in media rooms when I was the Speaker of the House that I knew they didn't like. We don't dislike Rocky, but I've been in environments where I thought it was going to be hostile when I got there. I love that he's coming in studio.
Yeah, well,
it's going to be a lot of fun.
I think Scott Howell was on last week.
That's right.
And we treated Scott Howell very well.
Here he is. Here's the man right here.
Here's Rocky right here. We'll let him take a seat. Rocky, first of all, Rocky, we wanted to ask you a question. We know you were coming down from the University of Utah. Is that right?
Right.
Yeah, you were coming. You didn't get a ticket, did you?
No, lucky I didn't get a ticket.
Because if you did, Aaron would have been the judge on this, and you know how that may have gone, Rocky.
They might be watching you closer now, Rocky. You know, watch out. Watch your back.
Yeah, that happened to me once before when I was mayor. And
did you get a ticket when you were mayor?
Oh, yeah. I got a twice. I just said, don't even think. Just give me the ticket. Don't.
Really?
Yeah,
they didn't give you any special treatment?
Never asked for it. Never wanted it.
All right. Well, big announcement today. Rocky, you announced you want another shot at being mayor.
Rocky 3.
Rocky 3.
And I know you have to be used to
right,
this.
That's right, but what I want, it's not about me at this point in my life.
Uh-huh.
It is about turning the city around. We're facing so many problems, and a lot of them we dealt with when I was mayor, and we had great accomplishments. We had great policing. Crime was down. We were dealing with homelessness issues in a way that we were recognized nationally. And this city right now has been so degraded, and I've seen it, and I tried to work with the mayor on some issues. I tried to work with a city council member. I wrote really nice, polite, I'm a concerned citizen. Can we maybe put up some public bathrooms that are safe and attended and not have human feces 50 feet away from Main Street or the front entrance to my beautiful, the historic renovated judge building being a public urinal, and the dismissiveness, the lack of response, the excuses, and then it was good enough for them to say, well, we'll use taxpayers' money to get a private company to come out and clean up if you want to give them a call. And I said, that's really good enough for you. No private dignity for these people who need to relieve themselves. No hygiene, and the rest of us, this is a city that we're going to be living in. And I said, you too, Sal, and I wrote this, and I've got the whole chain of these emails. And I said, if that's good enough for you, you don't belong there. You are nothing but a couple of more bureaucratic, do-nothing politicians, and I'm going to have to organize some folks, and we're going to have to push you to do your job. And then more and more things happen. I'd go downtown. People camped out on Main Street, these encampments everywhere, and then the police they just go in, and I know they're ordered from the top to go in and push them out from where they are. Take all their property, and then a police captain quoted in the newspaper, Captain Diamond, saying, well, we know when we push them out, they have no alternative, they're going to go somewhere else, and then we're going to be told to clear them out of there too. That is insane. It's not only insane, it's wasteful. We're paying these police time and a half to do this. We're paying our street division folks. I went down to one of these raids. I asked the guy in the truck, Salt Lake City Street Division.
Yep,
I said, how do you feel about this? He said, you know, I'm with Salt Lake City Streets Division. Our roads are crumbling around this city. I should be out laying asphalt today, and this is what they have me doing.
Yeah, Greg.
You know, Rocky, I got to tell you, Salt Lake City is our capital city. It's a Democrat city. You come with all the bona fides of being a rock-ribbed liberal Democrat. You and I politically, we haven't seen eye to eye on things. But let me tell you, I know. It's a sad story. I know. But here's what I've learned, especially hindsight being such a good teacher. there is something about a bias towards action. And I can tell you that watching you and in your time of public service, you've always had this bias towards action. And I think what you've just described about the circling of issues, the convening of issues, the avoiding of hard decisions, and even the criticism that comes with hard decisions. There is just a climate right now in Salt Lake City where doing nothing is coming at the worst consequence. And that is what I don't know about you. What I like about Rod, what I love about Rocky,
talking about this earlier,
is this man will stab me right in the chest, but not in the back. That's all I want. I just want it right in the chest.
A smile.
Not the back. Yeah. And a smile when he does it, Rod. That's what I love about the guy.
But we were talking earlier, Rocky. You're a guy who wants to get things done.
I do. That's why I'm doing this.
Come
this was not
water.
In my life plan.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's why I got involved in the first place in politics. I had a great law practice. My life was good. And I would fight powers that be. I was on several boards, Guadalupe School Board, ACLU Board, Planned Parenthood Board. The Common Cause Board, I'd fight against gifts to legislators. You might remember that one.
He never got a gift. He never got a gift.
I mean, it never got stingy when I arrived. There was nothing. There was no perks like that.
But, you know, I just have always felt strongly about we need to do what we can to make a better community and a better nation. And we've all got that responsibility. It's something that's sunk into me since studying philosophy in college, that we all have a huge responsibility, and you never really sit out your responsibility. If you decide not to do anything, then you're on the side of the status quo.
Yeah.
So that's always been my attitude, and right now there is so much work to be done. I've had the experience. I know how to get the job done, and I'm not crowing about myself. It takes a really great team. But you don't bring in your buddies. You don't bring in your political folks to do this work. And we've seen it now for at least two administrations.
Yeah, too long, that's
and
for sure.
I've had it. Yeah. I don't want to see property taxes going. I mean, we just had a property tax increase and this enormous bond that was just passed.
Yeah.
And we deserve a lot better than this, and they keep cutting back our services, city cleanup.
I
will bring that city cleanup back
to
Salt Lake.
Would you stay? Can you stay for another segment?
Yeah, you can stay for another segment.
One more segment?
Yeah. We don't want you in any trouble, Rocky. We don't want to
ruin your street cred on the show. You know, I mean, you're with a bunch of conservatives
here. I love you guys.
You're downhill. All right, Rocky Anderson with us here on Wingman Wednesday. More coming up on Utah's Talk Radio, 105.9 KNRS. You ever get sick and tired of hearing that song?
No, I love
Rocky.
The music. I love the thing, man. It just pumps me up. I want to go run up the Capitol steps.
You run up the Capitol steps and do the Rocky dance when you hear this.
I don't know anyone named Rocky. You're the only Rocky I know. I mean, it's perfect.
Well, that's a damn good thing because we've spent all this money on billboards and signs, you know?
Rocky Anderson, who announced today that he is going to run for Salt Lake City mayor again, is joining us here on Wingman Wednesday with Greg and Rod. And Rocky, you've talked about so much about the city, but is there, I just like to ask politicians this, the first thing you would do if you were elected and you were sworn into office, first thing you would do on day one?
I'm going to get people, collaborate with whoever we can, and politics doesn't enter into it.
Mm-hmm.
It was mentioned a while ago about we're a Democratic city. I'm not a member of a party anymore. I've had it with that. I've had it with political affiliations driving people, sometimes blindly and down the wrong path. I want to collaborate with those who have the means, and that's at the state, it's the county level, it's the philanthropy community, and we put together a plan for a central sanctioned camp, a place where there's bathrooms, which I couldn't get the mayor and this council member even to put in public bathrooms in our city. We'll have bathrooms, showers, laundry, food. It will be a place where people can come, and then we don't have these encampments anywhere else in the city. They will have that alternative. And then we don't just bring them in there. and leaving their own devices. There will be security, but there will also be transition services. There will be data kept on every person. How did they get here? What do they need? How are we going to move them out? I just worked to get a woman in Switch Point, which is a fantastic. You know, we talk about the bad news.
Yeah. There's some good stuff going on. Yeah,
Switch Point out on North Temple is amazing. I've been working with this homeless woman for, I've known her for probably 3 or 4 months now. Amazing story. We just got her into Switch. She moved in today.
Good.
When I knew that was arranged for, I had the sense of just feeling so happy. And I kept wondering, like, now why am I feeling? And it's like, yeah, this one, I'd say her name, but I think it's an invasion of her privacy perhaps. But she's a 65-year-old woman, had been a stagehand, member of the local union 99 of the stagehand workers, out of work because of COVID, out of her apartment and on the streets.
Wow.
I saw her sleeping in a gutter on 2nd South underneath the overpasses. It was so sad to me. I introduced her to the operator, the manager of Switch Point. She got her on the top of the list. She's just moved in today.
So we're with Rocky Anderson, former mayor of Salt Lake City from 2000 to 2008. Was that your time? So I am a property owner. I am small business owner in Salt Lake City. I started my business in 1996. And so I've seen a lot in the times where you were mayor, and we've had a number of different mayors. I have never had a time, and my business partner can speak to this probably better than I could, where we have been, our properties have been just accosted with the vandalism and the break-ins and it is just the expense that we have to go to try and keep the people that live in our buildings safe, to keep them from being broken into. It is a higher burden and cost and danger than it has ever been since 1996.
Try calling the police and then tell me how long it takes them to get there, if they ever show up.
Right.
Because there is such a sense of impunity right now, where the message being sent is you can do anything you want. You can sell drugs. You can shoot up in front of a police officer. You can smoke your meth. You can engage.
Have sex. You can have sex.
Or even engage in assaults, and nothing is going to happen. We had my announcement celebration today and the press conference at the Cake Salon at 1010 South State Street.
Yeah. We've had them on the air before.
7 fires around his building that were lit. And that was during the summer. It wasn't to stay warm.
Yeah.
One of the days was 104 degrees. Wow. There's human feces around. They have these drug parties. It's just absolutely outrageous what he, his clients, and his employees have to put up with. And the police tell him they're not going to do anything about it. And that's not doing anybody any good, because you're not going to get if there's a mental illness issue or there's a drug problem, they're not going to get any help if you just turn a blind eye to them. What do you do when you're in a family and somebody's got a drug problem or an alcohol problem? Oftentimes an intervention if it gets to that point. If we really consider these people our brothers and sisters, you need to intervene as a community. And don't, I'm not talking about punishing and retribution and putting people in jails and prison. I'm talking about getting them into the system so they will get the treatment and the services they need to turn their lives around and make this a safer, better community.
We have to go to a break, and I don't know that we'll have time to ask this question, but this has been in my experience, and you've been a public servant longer than me. You've been in this game, in the arena longer. Everyone agrees at 30,000 feet in the air what we should do. The moment you lower that plane down and you start to get into specifics and even locations that you're talking about, you're going to see a significant amount of community pushback and opposition to what you're talking about. I think that's why you see the inaction in this in City Hall today.
They don't like the pushback.
And you have to have a public servant ready to handle and actually turn people around and get them supportive, because right now, as soon as it gets close to the ground in terms of what you're going to do, if it is in anywhere in proximity to where they are, they push back ferociously.
Rocky, great seeing you.
Thank you very much.
Good luck with the campaign.
I mean, my view is restorative justice. You do things that restore people, the offenders, the victims, and the community as a whole, and there are solutions. So thank you for having me on.
Well, look, you're a fighter, and that city needs a fighter right now of all time. So you came here. So your game. You're not afraid of anything or anyone.
I love you guys. And, you know, it is all about action, and we will turn this place around.
All right, welcome back. Final half hour of the Wingman Wednesday with Rod and Greg here on Utah's Talk Radio, 105.9 KNRS. It was fun talking to Rocky. I hadn't seen Rocky for a long time. He looks good.
He does. He's in fighting shape. I'm telling you, the guy is fit and trim, ready to go. And I haven't seen him for ages. I was surprised. It was nice to see him.
Yeah.
And again, I'm all about bias towards action.